Good morning to one and all. I am Dr. Periyaswamy, head of the Department of Electronics and Communication Engineering. I am happy to say that I am given chance to give a tech talk on solar cooker, for which I am thankful to you, our beloved principal Sangeetha ma'am. Nowadays there are lot of necessities for solar cooker. Half the world population uses wood and dung to cook food. Wood cut for cooking destroy the forest of 16 million hectares annually. People are exposed to indoor air pollution as a result of burning solid fuels for cooking and heating. Nearly 1.2 billion people do not have access to clean drinking water. Over 1 million children die yearly because of unboiled drinking water. So these are all the overview of the topic. Cooking principle classification includes box cooker, panel cooker, parabolic cooker, and conclusions. The cooking principle of solar heater is like this. The sunlight is converted to heat energy, which is retained for cooking. The steps involved in solar cooker are concentration, capturing, and converting into solar energy. The classification of cookers includes three types. One is the direct type. It uses some solar energy concentrator to focus sunlight into an area. Example, parabolic solar cooker. The second is indirect type. It is a box covered with a transparent material like glass. Example, solar box cooker. Third, advanced type. The cooker uses either flat piece or focusing collector, which collect solar heat and transfer this to cooking vessel. Example, thermal storage solar cooker. The common types of solar cookers are box cookers, panel cooker, and parabolic cooker. So let us try to explain one by one. The box cooker consists of insulated box with a glass or a plastic window. The window acts as a solar energy trap by exploiting the greenhouse effect. Solar radiation passes through the window and is absorbed by the walls, the bottom of the cooker, and the cooking utensils. The parabolic cooker focuses a lot of sun energy into a very small space using parabolic shapes. Cooks nearly as fast as conventional oven, costly and complicated to make and use. That is, you have to turn frequently to follow the sun. The idea is, when the reflector's surface is aimed at the sun, the rays falling on the parabolic surface converges to the focus of the parabola. The cooking pot is placed at the focus of the reflector. The pot surfaces are blacked to improve the absorption. In panel cooker, the cooking pot is enclosed by a panel of reflectors. The sunlight is reflected off multiple panels onto a pot under the glass of lid or in a bag. Can be built quickly and at lower cost. It incorporates elements of both parabolic and box solar cookers. The reflective panel directs sunlight into dark colored pot. The pot is enclosed in an insulation cell such as high temperature cooking bag or an inverted bowl. The advantages and disadvantages of various types are displayed in the table. The major advantages of the solar cookers are like this. It is basically a renewable energy. Solar cooker does not require fuel. It preserves more of the natural nutrients of the plants. It preserves more of the natural nutrients of the foods by cooking at slower and lower temperature. Saves a lot of firewood. Can be used in areas where the fuel and firewood are available. It can be used in areas where the fuel and firewood are not available. The disadvantages are it is not continuous. It cannot be used during rainy season or cloudy condition. Performance could be affected by strong winds. The time required is higher than conventional cooking methods. In conclusion, I would like to say that cooking the food in solar cooker is healthy. The food does not lose vitamins and other nutrients. The solar cooker acts as a supernatural weapon to combat environmental issues like air pollution. Thanking you.